Hello and welcome to Bunbury Church Online. During this short 30-minute service, may you experience something of God's great love for you and the whole world. This morning, we begin a new series on the Beatitudes, a collection of 8 sayings of Jesus that sum up his teaching about what it means to live as a child of God. They're subversive, revolutionary, hard to live out, but truly beautiful and overflowing with God's blessing. They describe what life looks like when we, with the help of the Holy Spirit, become more like Christ. So let's sing our opening hymn, Blessed Assurance. Jesus said, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. Blessed are those who suffer persecution for righteousness' sake, and theirs is the kingdom of heaven." So let's say the following prayer together. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And a collect for today. God our Father, in Christ you make all things new. Transform the poverty of our nature by the riches of your grace, and in the renewal of our lives, make known the blessings of your Spirit, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now Claire Wilson is going to give today's reflection, our first on the Beatitudes. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Today we're beginning the series of looking at the Beatitudes, which form part of the Sermon on the Mount, which can be found in Matthew chapter 5. If Jesus were a public figure today, we'd likely summarise this chapter as his mountainside manifesto. It details the way for living a kingdom life, and as with all manifestos, the opening sentences set out the key elements to live a blessed life. The word blessed in modern terms has lost its impetus, as we bless people who sneeze and we use it to describe someone who has had a charmed life. But in biblical times, to be blessed meant that you were living your life as it was intended to be by the power of God. As a group of women who spent a whole year wrestling with the Sermon on the Mount said, unhappily for us, these words have become so familiar that they've lost their gut punch. So we asked, what would it be like to hear these words for the first time? Imagine a large and successful corporation gathering its employees to hear a motivational speech. We're expecting an attractive, self-confident, well-dressed presenter with large screens and slick gadgets. But instead, out walks an unremarkable man in ordinary clothes with nothing in his hands, not even notes. He sits down on a chair and begins, if you want to be successful in work and life, become acquainted with your own poverty. If you want to be rich, give away all your profit. We're stunned. Worse than that, we're uncomfortable. We fidget and we try to look away. But he's captured us by his words and his voice, and he's found our hearts. We instinctively know that he's telling the truth. As much as we'd like to run, the hook is in. To whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. So these pithy little statements were controversial and powerful. They rocked the status quo of the way people thought the world worked. At that time, if you were wealthy, it was assumed that you had found approval in God's eyes. And if your life was marked with difficulty, then God had somehow turned his back on you. The favour of God was assumed to rest on those who knew the Mosaic law and lived respectable religious lives. But that day, Jesus blew this out of the water with his opening sentence, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. What did he say? Did we hear him right? Could it possibly be me, the one who never quite seems to get things right? Me, the one who life seems to want to kick whilst I'm down? Me, the one who knows I'll never be good enough to earn God's favour? I'm the one who has been given the greatest gift of life with our loving God. You see this empty glass? The person who knows that they are spiritually poor and realises their need of God, his love and grace and mercy, they can be filled by the gift of the Holy Spirit. So in all circumstances, we can allow God's love, joy, peace, patience, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control to overflow from us. So not only are we blessed, but we bless others. but what of the regular churchgoer? You know your Bible inside out. You're a capable and confident person who's successful. Where does all that leave me? Well, our job is a little harder. We humble ourselves, lay aside any self-congratulations, and recognise that we too are in need of the power that only God gives. In our reliance on the goodness of God, we are given the greatest gift of life also. Life with our loving God, so we too can overflow and bless others.
Thanks, Claire, for that brilliant message. Now for a musical interlude, "And the Lord Bless You and Keep You," sung by St. Paul's Cathedral Choir. Now John Mason is going to lead us in our prayers.
Today we hear again Jesus' words, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of God." We pray that we might appreciate the shock of these words as they turn normal values on their head. We give thanks. We are not part of a competition to be more spiritual than others, but we have an individual relationship with you, Lord, where there is no place for pretense. You know all and you accept us as we are, with our good and bad parts, and always with love. Help us to remember that being poor in spirit is not a sign of failed faith, but a sign that we are ready and open to learn and to grow. May we recognize that we need your help and humble ourselves and set aside any self-congratulation. We are in need of the power that only you can give, and we pray that as we are given the greatest gift of life with you, our living God, so our own spirit will overflow and bless others. Lord, we see a troubled world around us. Many have concerns over health and finance. There have been disappointments and anxieties for students. Migrants are fleeing their homes out of fear. Ongoing wars continue to bring destruction and loss of life. There are global political uncertainties and corrupt regimes. There is scaremongering and an inability to know what is true. But Lord, you are sovereign. We thank you that you have given us the means and the hope to address all these earthly matters, and that you care deeply about them as a parent cares for a child. Give us the poorness of spirit to put our trust in you. And we pray that we will always stay close to you, living out our everyday lives as you would wish. Let us demonstrate your love for us by showing a similar love to others, especially those with whom we might disagree or who are not one of us. Let us follow the selfless example of those we have admired, those key workers who have helped others to cope with the difficulties of the pandemic. We see your love working through others all around us, and we praise you for that. And let us spend a moment thinking especially of those we know who are currently in need, the sick, the bereaved. And finally, this beatitude of Jesus brings to mind that wonderful prayer attributed to St. Francis, which reflects his humility of spirit and how apparent contradictions are wonderfully resolved through the Christian faith. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring love. Where there is offence, let me bring pardon. Where there is discord, let me bring union. Where there is error, let me bring truth. Where there is doubt, let me bring faith. Where there is despair, let me bring hope. And where there is darkness, let me bring light. Where there is sadness, let me bring joy. O Master, let me not seek as much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that one receives. It is in self-forgetting that one finds. It is in pardoning that one is pardoned. And it is in dying that one is raised to eternal life. Amen.
Thank you, John, for those lovely prayers. Now, birthdays, and congratulations to Ernest Johnson and Barbara Crowley, both celebrating birthdays this week. Many, many happy returns from us all. Also, our congratulations go to Dorothy and Kenneth Donald, celebrating this week their diamond wedding anniversary. A remarkable achievement. Much love from all of us. And finally, thank you to all of you who've sent in lovely messages about the photo we took at the beginning of lockdown, being selected by the National Portrait Gallery to be part of their Hold Still exhibition, 100 photos of lockdown. We were delighted that the Duchess of Cambridge, who chaired the panel, chose to put three of her favourite photos on her Instagram page, and ours was one of them. And I must say a big thank you to Lynn Hedgecoe, who encouraged us to enter the competition. Lynn is part of our new virtual community. She was initially told about our online services by Joyce Buxton and saw the photo during our opening slides and emailed to say how much she'd enjoyed the service and loved the photo, and told me about the National Portrait Gallery's competition. Well, fast forward a couple of months, there were over 31,000 entries. So to be chosen as one of the 100 is a real privilege. And we're really excited to be part of such an amazing project. More details to follow. But for now, let's sing our final hymn, Blessed Be Your Name.
Blessed be your name in the land that is plentiful, where your streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name when I'm found in the desert place, though I walk through the wilderness. Blessed be your name.
So a final blessing. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and all those you love today and forever. Amen. So this week, when we've started to think about the Beatitudes, Jesus' Mountainside Manifesto, I leave you with the Grammy Award-winning singer-songwriter Tracy Chapman talking about a revolution.
Don't you know, talking about a revolution, it sounds don't you know, we're talking about a revolution. It sounds like a whisper. While they're standing in the welfare lines, crying at the doorsteps of those armies of salvation, wasting time in the unemployment lines, sitting around waiting for a promotion. Don't you know, about a revolution, it sounds so sweet. We're gonna deserve. Take what's there. The doorsteps of those armies of salvation, wasting time in the unemployment lines, sitting around waiting for a promotion. Don't you know, talking about a revolution sounds. Final minute tables are starting to turn, talking about a revolution. Starting to turn, talking about a revolution. Oh, oh, no. Talking about a revolution. Oh, oh, no. Talking about a revolution. Oh, oh. Get their share. Who are people gonna rise up and take what's theirs? Don't you know you better run, 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 run? Oh, I said you better run, 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 run. Starting to turn, talking about a revolution. It's finally the tables are starting to turn, talking about a revolution. Oh, oh no, talking about a revolution. Oh, oh no, talking about a revolution. Oh, oh no.